Hello everyone. We are 1SMBB Group 12. We are Chin Xian, Esther Wendy, Kunabilla, Nor Raihanas, and Sawawa. Eat to live, not live to eat. To the best knowledge we know, nearly half of the world's people consume rice as the staple. And more than 90% of this rice is consumed in Asia. Here's an important idea to remember. Like many Asians prefer rice as the staple, the bacteria too. Many bacteria such as E. coli prefer glucose uptake. Why bacteria prefer glucose? This is because most bacterial cells like E. coli grows faster on glucose than on any other carbon source. So how the bacteria take up glucose? Here's what we are going to share with you. That is group translocation, the phosphotransferase system. Group translocation is an energy-dependent mechanism utilized by bacteria to transport a compound into the cell. Sounds similar to active transport. However, the group translocation differs a bit from the active transport because the chemical composition of compound transported is altered. Generally, it is by phosphorylation. In E. coli, glucose is being phosphorylated to glucose 6-phosphate during the group translocation. And note that this is the first step of glycolysis. Glucose 6-phosphate is the intracellular transport product while glucose molecule is the extracellular transport substrate. Since the product appears inside the cell is chemically different from the external substrate, therefore no actual concentration gradient of external solute cachet is produced. Let's recap what we have learnt about the group translocation. Now, we are going to talk about an example of group translocation, which is the phosphotransferase system, PTS, or PEP group translocation. But why is it so called? As a matter of fact, it is a distinct method used by bacteria for sugar uptake where the source of energy is from phosphenolpyruvate PEP. Let us see how it works. In order for bacteria to get sugars through PTS, the phosphate group from the high-energy PEP compound is transferred to the phosphoryl transfer proteins in PTS. Then, it is broken down to form pyruvate. Besides, PTS involves the cytoplasmic proteins and membrane proteins. Enzyme 1, HPR and enzyme 2A are cytoplasmic proteins while enzyme 2B and enzyme 2C are membrane proteins. Enzyme 1 and HPR are non-specific components participating in all phosphotransferase reactions whereas enzymes 2 are specific for the uptake of each kind of sugars. By PTS, different sugars can be transported into bacteria, including glucose, mannose, fructose and cellobiose. PTS sugars transported differ from one bacterial group to another, reflecting the most suitable carbon sources available in the environment every group evolved. Let's sum up the phosphotransferase system. Thank you for watching. Created using Powtoon.